potential at a point due to a point charge is given by this relation. V is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 q by r. So for a positive charge, nearer points are at a higher potential. Potential at a point is defined as the amount of work done for taking a unit positive charge from infinity to that point. When you take a positive charge, this positive will be repelling it. So we have to do work. That is why potential is a positive quantity for a positive charge. So potential is a quantity which is greater than zero. Now, when we are moving away, this r will be going on increasing. So this v will be going on decreasing. At last, when r is infinity, potential will be zero. So potential will be zero at infinity. When it is a negative charge, when you try to bring a positive charge, this negative charge will be attracting. So for a negative charge, potential is a negative quantity. It is a quantity which is lesser than zero. For a negative charge, nearer points are at lesser potential. As we are going away, potential will be going on increasing and finally it will become zero. That you can see from this expression also. When we are moving away, this r is going on increasing, so this quantity will be decreasing. But because of this negative sign, it will be increasing. So for a negative charge, as we are moving away, potential will be going on increasing and it will become zero. From negative value, it is going on increasing and then it will become zero. Now we'll make a comparison between electric field and the gravitational field. Surrounding a mass, there is a region. That is what is called the gravitational field. Now you consider a body in a gravitational field. In a gravitational field, body will be moving from a higher potential to lower potential. That you are very familiar. It will be moving from a higher potential to lower potential. In the case of electric field, there are different situations because there are two types of charges, positive charge and negative charge. First, you consider positive charge. You consider three points, P, Q, R. For a positive charge, nearer points are at a higher potential. So VP is greater than VQ. VQ is greater than VR. So that already we completed. For a positive charge, nearer points are at a higher potential. Now you keep a test charge, Q dash. Positive charge you keep. This positive. Positive, positive, there will be repulsion. So it will be moving along this direction, away from the charge. That means it is moving from a higher potential to lower potential. So positive charge will be moving from a higher potential to lower potential. Now you consider a negative charge. For a positive charge, nearer points are at a higher potential, but this negative charge will be attracted by this positive charge. So it will be moving in the opposite direction, here that side, here this side. That means negative charge will be moving from a lower potential to higher potential. It will be moving from a lower potential to higher potential. Now you consider a negative charge. For a negative charge, nearer points are at lesser potential. So Vp is lesser than Vq. P is nearer this charge, so potential at P is lesser. Now you keep a positive charge. So this positive charge will be attracted by this negative charge. So it will be moving along this direction. That means a positive charge will be moving from higher to lower. Same as this one. Here also higher to lower, but here also higher to lower. For a positive charge, nearer points are at a higher potential. For a negative charge, points which are away will be at a higher potential. So it is moving from a higher potential to lower potential. So positive charge will always move away from a higher potential to lower potential, like a body in a gravitational field. But a negative charge, now you consider a negative charge. This negative, this negative, this negative. There will be repulsion, so it will be moving along that direction. That means it will be moving from a lower potential to higher potential. So positive charge will move from higher to lower. Negative charge will move from lower to higher. Electric potential at a point due to a system of point charges. We know potential at a point due to a single charge, that is given by this relation V is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q by R. When there are number of charges, we have to add, finding the potential at this point due to individual charges, then we have to find out the sum. Potential here, because of the first charge, is K Q1 by R1. For 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0, we are putting K constant. Then here charge is Q1, distance is R1. So this is the potential at this point because of Q1. Q1 is at a distance of R1. Next, potential here because of Q2. Q2 is at a distance of R2. Potential here because of Q2 is K Q2 by R2, where K is 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0. Like that, we have to find out the potential at this point due to Q3, Q4, etc. Then last, Qn. Qn is at a distance of Rn. So this is the potential at the point P, which is at a distance of Rn. Now, total potential is given by this relation. So here K can be taken outside. So then the summation can be represented as sigma. Then general charge can be taken as Qi, then distance as Ri, where I is changing from 1 to n. Then the value of K can be written as 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0, then summation sigma I is equal to 1 to n Qi by Ri. So this will give you the potential at a point due to a system of charges.